HarperCollins and Harper Audio present Cinders and Sparks, Fairies in the Forest by Lindsey Kelk. Performed by Shaina Summerville. Chapter 1.
Hansel! Cinders squealed. If you don't loosen your grip, you're going to be walking the rest of the way to Fairyland.
Perhaps you ought to let me be in front for a while,
Hansel replied, slackening his arms just a little.
I'm very strong, and I wouldn't mind if you needed to hold on to me to feel safe.
You're going to need more than something to hold on to feel safe in a minute, Cinders muttered back. My horse, my quest, my rules.
Cinders was on a very important mission to find out some very important things, and it was bad enough having to listen to Sparks, her magical talking dog, rattle on about sausages or lack thereof, without a boy in a silly hat giving her grief. Every time Mouse the horse... Mouse was a mouse who Cinders had accidentally turned into a horse, but that was another story altogether. Took a sharp turn to avoid running into a tree or off the edge of a cliff, Hansel would let out a terrible shriek and squeeze Cinder's waist so tight she thought she might snap in two.
Perhaps you shouldn't have invited him along in the first place,
Sparks suggested from his comfortable position curled up in front of Cinder's, his muzzle resting in Mouse's mane.
Excuse me, you were the one who said he should come along when he offered you those sausages, Cinders reminded him.
Honestly, Sparks, I don't think there's anything you wouldn't do for a sausage.
Sparks considered this for a moment, decided there was a good chance that she might be right, and so said nothing. It felt as though they'd been riding for days, but really it had only been a few hours since Cinders had escaped King Picklebottom's guards and fled the palace. But as they rode deeper into the forest and the air grew chilly, she was starting to wonder if they'd made the right decision. Long, spindly branches wove themselves together overhead, blocking out the sun, and the farther they went, the darker and darker and darker the sky became, until Cinders could barely see her hand in front of her face. Thankfully, she was very, very brave. Most of the time. She wasn't afraid of anything. King Picklebottom, the Dark Forest, Munkle Poops, Gadzoozles, or Nobbledyzooks. Not that she'd ever been in the Dark Forest before, or met a Munkle Poop, Gadzoozle, or Nobbledyzook in real life. All she knew was that she had to get to Fairyland. Just a week ago, she'd been living in the countryside with her father and her stepsisters and her really rather awful stepmother. An ordinary girl with an ordinary life. And then, one day, out of nowhere, her fairy godmother had arrived, and Cinders had started to develop magic powers. And everything had changed.
Cinders!
Hansel ducked his head to avoid getting slapped in the chops by a low-hanging branch.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, Hansel.
You said your mom was a fairy.
Yes, Hansel.
Which means you're a half-fairy.
Yes, Hansel.
So why don't you cast a spell and magic us all to Fairyland rather than riding through the dark forest?
Cinders sighed. If they'd been through this once, they'd been through it 1,000 times. Because my magic isn't strong enough, she said as she flicked Mouse's reins, encouraging him to go just a little bit faster. I only found out I was half-fairy a week ago. These things don't work themselves out overnight, you know. I mean, if I'd been more in control of my powers, I wouldn't have made that pig come back to life at dinner. I wouldn't have scared the king, he wouldn't have decided I was a witch, and we wouldn't have had to run away in the first place.
Cinders couldn't help but wonder if it wouldn't have been easier to just stay at the palace, marry Prince Joderick, and behave herself. Except, she didn't want to marry Prince Joderick, and she never had been very good at behaving herself. But now she was lost in the forest with the palace guards after her, and the only thing she could think to do was go to Fairyland, where her mother apparently came from, and try to get some answers.
Fair enough, said Hansel.
He closed his eyes as Mouse leaped over a fallen tree trunk and thundered on, deeper into the forest.
One more question. Do you think your magic might be strong enough to find us a toilet? I really have to go.
Truly, she should have left that boy where she'd found him.
It's not my fault,
he wailed when she spurred Mouse on to ride faster.
It's all this jiggling around on the back of the horse. I drank a massive bottle of elderberry juice this morning, and I've been holding it in for ages.
Can't you wait 10 more minutes? She asked.
Not unless you want an accident, he grumbled. And I don't think that's a good idea on the back of a horse.
All Cinders wanted to do was keep riding, avoid being eaten by a Munklepoop, get to Fairyland, and solve the mystery of how her mother had found her way into the kingdom, met her dad, given birth to Cinders, and left her with a magical talking dog. Was that really too much to ask for?
All right, we'll stop.
Cinders closed her eyes, concentrated very hard, and took a deep breath. I wish we could find somewhere for Sparks to eat some sausages, Mouse to get some cheese, and Hansel to have a pee, because he's a useless boy who can't even hold it in for a minute.
Oh, really?
Sparks sniffed, turning up his shiny black nose.
There's no need to be vulgar.
All at once, Cinders felt a tingling in her fingertips. As they reached the darkest part of the dark forest, her hands began to glow silver and gold, thousands of tiny lights flickering brightly all around her.
Oh, I say! Hansel grabbed hold of his green felt hat. What's she doing? What do you mean, what's she doing?
Sparks asked a little indignantly.
She's using her magic to find you a bathroom, just like you asked.
Hansel looked shocked, the rosy red color disappearing from his round cheeks.
So, she really is half fairy? Not everyone is a fibber, replied Sparks.
Hansel went very quiet. He had a reputation as a world-class porcupine teller, and not without good reason. Look! The light from Cinder's hands suddenly began to flow outward, carving a golden path through the pitch black of the forest floor. I think we're supposed to go this way.
Follow me!
Sparks cried bravely, hopping down from Mouse's saddle to race ahead of his friends.
So you can smell the sausages as well?
Cinders asked.
Certainly can, he confirmed. Top-notch wishing, Cinders. Very well done.
Chapter 2 A few minutes later, the golden path faded away and the foursome found themselves in a little clearing. Cinders looked up and saw stars in the night sky. It was much later than she'd realized. In the middle of the clearing was a sweet little cottage. The walls were white and the roof was thatched, and there was an archway of roses growing around the wooden front door.
Really very well done, Cinders,
Sparks said as he bounded up to the cottage, marveling at the perfectly tended little garden full of pretty flowers.
All the better to pee on later,
he thought to himself. Let's see if anyone is home, Cinders said, straightening her shoulders and trying to tidy her messy hair. She held up her non-sparkly hand and knocked on the door. No one answered.
Knock again,
Hansel suggested, crossing his legs and doing a little dance from side to side.
Louder this time. They probably couldn't hear it. Perhaps they're in the kitchen cooking,
Sparks agreed with his eyes closed. Something inside smelled very good indeed. And so Cinders knocked again, but there was still no answer.
Try the door,
Sparks suggested, popping his paws up on the windowsill and peeking in. Cinders gave a cross little sigh. She really, really, really wanted to get on with her journey. Honestly, Sparks, nice people don't go around leaving their front doors unlocked for just anyone to walk in and... The handle turned in her hand, the door opened, and Hansel raced past her and disappeared down the hallway. "Hello?" Cinders called. "Is anyone home?" She turned on a lamp to get a better look at the place, which appeared to be empty. In the living room, there was a fireplace, and in front of it was one big chair, one medium-sized chair, and one little chair. Walking into the kitchen, she saw a large wooden table. Placed around it was one big chair, one medium-sized chair, and one little chair.
"Would you look at that?"
Sparks bounded up onto the smallest chair, walked around in a circle, and plopped his red, fluffy tail down on the comfy cushion.
"Perfectly Sparks-sized."
Still not altogether sure about being in someone else's house uninvited, Cinders tapped an uncertain finger on the arm of the biggest chair. It was awfully late, and she was awfully tired. It had been a peculiar day, to say the least. She was only having a sit-down, after all. Surely no one would mind. "Good golly gosh, that's a comfy chair," she gasped as she sank into the cushion. She could have closed her eyes and gone to sleep right there and then.
"Cinders! Sparks!"
Quick as a flash, Cinders and her doggy pal ran off to find out what was wrong with Hansel.
"Hansel, even I know you shouldn't wear your shoes in bed."
The bothersome boy was in the bedroom, in a great big bed with the covers tucked up to his chin.
"It's so soft," he said,
plucking off his hat and placing it on the bedside table.
"And look, there's one for each of us. It's as if they knew we were coming."
Sure enough, just like in the kitchen and the living room, the bedroom had one big bed, one medium-sized bed, and one little bed. And Cinders was awfully tired.
"I hate to agree with Hansel, but I think he's got the right idea here," Sparks said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.